Tonight, the organ can treat the creature clubly at Marigold Lake. Chapter 5. Row, row, row your boat. Back at the cabin, Stuart was very sorry when he saw how upset Ellie was. After all, he was the one who had put the idea of snakes in her head. To make it up to the girls, he offered to take them on a canoe ride. "I'll row the rowboat," Stuart said. "You guys ride in the canoe. We can tie the two together and we'll tail you around the lake." Ellie cheered up right away. "That sounds fun," she said, beaming at Stuart. "But could I ride with you?" Stuart sucked her. "If you want it," he said. The five of them put on life jackets. Then Stuart tied a rope line from the back of the rowboat to the front of the canoe. So Stuart was rowing them out in the middle of the lake in the canoe. Marion, Amy, and Liz loomed and relaxed. "I could get used to this," Marion said. "Me too," said Liz. "Stuart has never ever rowed me around the lake before." The late afternoon sun was getting low in the sky. The water on the lake was still, except for the pools made by Stuart's oars. Liz sighed. It was a peaceful, happy, perfect moment. Just then, on the far side of the lake, a very large bird came splashing down to the water as it landed. Annie gasped, "Wow!" she cried. "Is that a great blue heron?" She leaped to her feet, straining to see. "Wait!" Liz cried. "Don't stand!" It was too late. Amy teetered, then lost her balance. She fell out of the canoe, her foot catching the side. The whole canoe flipped, dumping Marion and Liz too. When Liz came out from under the water, the first thing she heard was Stuart laughing. But Liz didn't mind. She started laughing too. Liz had lost track of the number of times she and Stuart had tipped the canoe over the years. Marion started giggling too. "Good thing I bought an extra pair of shoes," she said. "Are you guys okay?" Ellie called from the rowboat. Liz could tell Ellie was trying to laugh at her wet friend, not to laugh at her wet friend. The only one who did not look amused was Amy. Liz recognized the familiar flush of pink on her cheeks. Amy was completely embraced. Bye.